I want to welcome everybody here. Thanks for this opportunity to come and speak and let you guys know how the season's kind of been progressing for us. So when I got here in April, a lot of new faces, a lot of new people, a new system for a lot of our current returners. We get through summer, we're in the preseason here, and we had eight new freshmen coming into the program, and for them it's kind of been, they don't know anything else, so it's been easy. Our returners have had a new system to kind of follow. And if you look at our team, we have a relatively young team. We only have two seniors this year, one of them being Seth Gross, a returning national champion. So this preseason has gone absolutely phenomenal. We've been able to focus a lot on developing our student athletes. I think that is the most important thing. Us as mentors here, we want to provide a culture of growing, right? We want to mentor these kids, not only on the mat, but in the classroom and in life. So preseason has been going absolutely phenomenal. We just started our official practices on the October 10th, and we're kind of right in the swing of things. That preseason, what we're trying to do is build that foundation, build that base, so when we hit into the season, they already have everything they need, and then we're just kind of fine-tuning throughout that year. And that's kind of important because, it's crazy in wrestling, listen to some of the other coaches talk, it never stops. I mean, our guys are training mostly year-round, and we train all year for 3 days in March. I mean, that's what it comes down to. So this year, how our schedule is set up, it's kind of, we're trying to peak only a couple times throughout that year. And obviously, at the end goal is March. So leading up to our first duel, which is in a couple weeks down at the Pentagon, be my first event down there. I know there's been others, but I'm truly excited. They run a first-class service, and I'm looking forward to the hospitality that they're going to provide, and we're bringing in Arizona State. So another top 20 team, and I'm looking to, put a product out on that mat that our fans, that our friends of the program are proud of, where they're going to go out there and they're going to compete hard. They're going to see a lot of new faces in that lineup. We graduated, I believe, eight or nine seniors. Two of them All-Americans, one a Big 12 champion. So you're going to see a lot of new faces. You're going to see a lot of new faces at different weight classes as well. 125 for us is kind of an open weight right now. We have three guys competing for that spot. At 133, you have returning national champion Seth Gross. At 141, returning an NCAA qualifier Henry Pohlmeier. At 49, you could see a new face in the lineup. We have a couple different guys, one being a retro freshman Peyton Smith and a retro freshman Eric Williams that appear. At 157, why am I drawing a blank right now? Let me see here. What? Oh God. So 157, a familiar face, but a different weight class. Carlson, goodness gracious. Colton Carlson will be moving up from 149 pounds, where he kind of had a rough freshman year, kind of struggled a little bit with the weight, but he'll be moving up to 157 pounds this year. I'm expecting big things out of him. Tireless work ethic, phenomenal young man, and he's been really, really growing through this process. And so I'm expecting big things out of Colton at 157 pounds. 165, we have our other senior, Logan Peterson. And Logan Peterson last year was a match or two away from qualifying for the national tournament. coming into his senior year, he's kind of bought into the system, and he's looking better than I think he's ever been. And going into this year, we're expecting big things out of him as well. 174 pounds is kind of an open weight for us. We have a couple different guys, one being a South Dakota boy out of Vermilion, Brett By, and a young man out of Ohio, Garrett Jordan. They'll probably be fighting it out at 174 pounds. At 184 pounds, you're going to see not a new face, but a new weight class. He was 165 pounder last year. He's going up to 184 pounds. Zach Carlson out of Minnesota, and he has made a great transition. great transition. Last year, he kind of had some bumps and bruises, some injuries. Keeping him healthy, I think, is going to be the biggest thing going into this year. And I'm expecting some big things out of him. Another new face at a weight is going to be Marty Mueller. Marty Mueller is going up from 184 pounds last year up to 197 pounds. He was a national qualifier for us. And I think the move up a weight for Marty is going to be tremendous for him. If anybody's got a chance to see Marty, he's an athlete. He's a competitor when he's out there competing. And I think the move up the weight, where he's not going to have to cut a little bit, he can get bigger and stronger, and he's going to be too athletic for those big guys. So I think he's going to have a good year looking forward. At heavyweight, we lost Alex Mackey last year. Great young man, and so we have a couple underclassmen filling in for that spot. One of them being probably Blake Walters, who is a redshirt freshman out of Minnesota. So with that being said, we have a young team, but the expectation does not change. Okay, the bar does not drop. So we want to go out there. We want to win conference tournaments. We want to contend for trophies at that national tournament. And I think we set the standard high. So these guys, they know what to expect. And honestly, when we recruit these kids and come into our program, they expect that of themselves. So it's our job to kind of keep them on that task. And so far, everything's been great. We have, our first home duel, Arizona State at the Pentagon. I hope everybody here can make it. And then our first home duel is Oklahoma State the following weekend. We open up with them. They're a top five program. It'll be the same weekend as the USD football game. So we're going to piggyback off that. And we want to pack the house. Let's pack the house in Frost and create that environment that I have been told about, that it's hell on wheels to wrestle here. And let's pack that house and make it impossible for them to compete at their best. So, and then lastly, I mentioned Seth Gross, our returning national champion. He will be competing again in the All-Star match that will be the first weekend in November out in Denver. And he'll be competing against a guy that he wrestled in the semifinals, Tariq Wilson out of NC State. So he's going to have some good competition right away, right out of the gates. But I think in regards to Seth, he has his goals, his visions of winning another national title, but I don't think it stops there. I think, when he leaves his program, he wants to leave his legacy behind. And it's not about winning a second national title. It's going to be about the fashion that he does it in. All right, he's going to go out there and dominate the competition and leave his mark forever on SDSU. So that's a quick update. I try to keep it as short as possible. And thank you, and go Jacks.